Greetings to God's people, wherever you might be, as we join together virtually this Lord's Day for worship here in the sanctuary of St. Matthew's Church in Glendale, California. We gather this day to celebrate the ascension of our Lord. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, so often we have listened to the voices of the world that would claim that self is all there is to consider in this life. Too often we have been unwilling to follow your example and put the needs and well-being of others first, even as you did in allowing us to nail you to the cross. Forgive us and help us more and more to love others. Amen. In today's readings, the risen Jesus ascends into heaven. And Jesus' followers are assured that the Spirit will empower them to be witnesses throughout the earth. The disciples were told to not gaze up into heaven to look for Jesus. We find Jesus' presence among us as we proclaim the word and share Easter. We, too, long for the Spirit to enliven our faith and invigorate our mission. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Seeing we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, and make our confession to our Heavenly Father. Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, your word is a light to our path. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. God raised Jesus from the dead and enthroned Jesus at God's right hand in the heavenly realms. God put all things in subjection beneath Jesus' feet and gave Jesus as head over all things to the church. We died, and our life lies hidden with Jesus in God. We set our minds on things above. When Jesus, our life, is revealed, then we too will be revealed with Jesus in glory. Jesus has gone up on high. Alleluia. I heard the voice of a great multitude crying, Alleluia. The Lord our God has entered into God's kingdom. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Alleluia. Jesus says, peace is my parting gift to you, my own peace, such as the world cannot give. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. The peace of Jesus be with you always and also with you. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be God's kingdom forever. Alleluia. Christ has gone up on high. Alleluia. Let us pray. Almighty God, your only Son was taken into the heavens and in your presence intercedes for us. Receive us and our prayers for all the world, and in the end, bring everything into your glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, whom with you and the Holy Spirit we worship and praise, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. How about we give God a great big praise in this place today? Come on, we put a little bit of a twist. Oh, Lord, I lift your name on high. Can you clap with us right now? Come on, let me do it. Come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Hey. Come on, sing. Lord, I lift.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I
love.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach until the day he was taken up to heaven. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed himself to these men and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. Oh, yeah. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. So when they met together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? To Israel. He said to them, it is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. After he said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. They were looking intently up into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. Men of Galilee, they said, why do you stand here the sky? This same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. This is Acts chapter 1 verses 1 through 11.
Grace Christian.
Acts 6, 1 through 7. And in those days, when the number of the disciples was multiplied, there arose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews, because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration. Then the 12 called the multitude of the disciples unto them, and said, it is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. But we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. The saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Ghost, and Philip, and Prochorus, and Nicanor, and Timon, and Parmenas, and Nicholas, a proselyte of Antioch, whom they set before the apostles. And when they had prayed, they laid their hands on them. And the word of God increased, and the number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient to the faith. Acts 6:1-7.
From the Gospel according to Luke chapter 24, verses 44 through 53. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple blessing God. And this is the word of the Lord.
In the name of the living God and his crucified, risen, and ascended Christ, our Lord Jesus. Amen. Please be seated. They had abandoned him. They had denied him. They were utterly confused about the most important parts of his teaching. In jealousy and in competition, they fought amongst themselves about who was greater. They showed an incredible lack of faith all the time. And yet, after he had risen from the dead, the Lord Jesus chose to spend an extra 40 days with those yahoos known as the disciples. You wouldn't have done that if you had been Jesus. Neither would I. That's not the way we work it. When people forsake us, we forsake them back. When people curse us and deny our friendship, we block them, cut them off. When people misunderstand us or misinterpret us or what we're all about, we respond with exasperation or resentment. You could say that we are the peace out people. See you later. Ain't got time for this. I am so done. But not our Lord Jesus. He has given every reason to never speak to them again, those disciples. Yet he continues with them for 40 days after the resurrection. He stays with them. He forgives them. He breathes peace upon them. Instead of peace out, our Lord is peace in with his disciples and with us. But now, as you see in the image that we have before you, it's time for him to physically leave their presence. This is the ascension that we're talking about. After 40 days of preparation with them, it's time for him to physically leave their presence. How difficult this must have been for them. The image that I have before you this evening helps us maybe picture a little bit some of the human emotions that they certainly would have been experiencing as they felt what it was like to be away from Jesus, yet then he's there with them, and now he said he's going to leave them, what they would be feeling. And I want you to look at this image that we have and maybe pick out which face would be yours. We've got the disciples, we've got the Blessed Virgin Mary, we've got other people gathered around there on the Mount of the Ascension. What would you be feeling? Which face might be yours after all that they had been through together? As Pastor mentions, the church calls this the Ascension because it's the day when Jesus Christ ascended bodily unto glory to be enthroned as King and ruler over all things. And there, my friends, he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And there, even now, this evening, whatever is happening in the world around us, whatever is happening in our hearts, he is there amid the sights and sounds of eternity. A wondrous glory that we can't even imagine. In today's gospel account and in the reading from Acts, he's about to leave them. And as he leaves them, his departure is like some of our departures that we have. Mixed emotions, I imagine. Sadness and maybe joy. Apprehension, maybe exhilaration. Questions, uncertainty. But as he prepares to leave them, he leaves them with two promises. And these two promises I want you to take with you this evening as well. There are things that he has promised to the disciples and to us and to the church for all time. And the first promise is that though he is
Oh,
let us join our prayers with those of our Savior, seeking the Father's blessing and the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus Christ, pray to the Father. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, great high priest, living forever to intercede for us, pray for the church, your broken body in the world, and especially for the members of St. Matthew's Church. Jesus Christ, pray to the Father. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of the Majesty on high, pray for the world and make it subject to your gentle rule. Jesus Christ, pray to the Father. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God, pray for our brothers and sisters in need, distress, sorrow, or sickness, and especially those who mourn the loss of loved ones. Jesus Christ, pray to the Father. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, head of all things, ascending far above the heavens and filling the universe, pray for all who receive the gifts you give for work in your service. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, send us the Spirit. Jesus Christ, keep the church in the unity of the Spirit and in the bond of your peace, and bring the whole created order to worship at your feet, for you are alive and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you have raised humanity in Jesus. Mercifully grant that with such spiritual blessings, we may set our hearts in the heavenly places, in Jesus' name. Amen. God the Father, who has given to his Son the name above every name, strengthen you to proclaim Jesus as Lord. God the Son, who is the great high priest passed into the heavens, plead for you at the right hand of the Father. God the Holy Spirit, who pours out abundant gifts upon the church, make you faithful servants of Jesus Christ our King. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Amen.